But as we begin the night, we're not going to start today, or yesterday, or the day before. We're going back weeks, months, years, perhaps? You wake up. A brief nap. The days, it's hard to stay awake. A familiar couch. A fairly pleasant moss covering the interior, the wooden interior, that not of man-made. You find yourself in a, appears to be the trunk of a tree. A place that you've visited often as of late. A friend of yours visits you more regularly than normal. As time seems to be coming to a close for you. You can feel the weakness in your body. You have an understanding, but have come to terms with what's happening to you. You look up and find your friend, who is currently pouring a pot of tea. He's a fairly large fellow. He has skin, that of the bark of a tree. He's got a large mushroom-bin hat. That is clearly his own head, but provides shade, regardless. And numerous vines running down his body. Rife with life, they regularly bloom, depending on his mood. He comes to you, and he hands you a cup of tea. You take a quick whiff of it. Smells. The usual smell. Ah, you recognize it. Life bloom tea. A pleasant, refreshing taste. Gives you the feeling of warmth on the inside, but a cool, refreshing feeling on the outside. But this particular tea's benefits stopped affecting you long ago. How are you feeling this morning?
I'm doing good.
It's been nice having you around. As you look upon this man, and you know him as Nock. He lifts you up out of your chair and takes you. You struggle to walk, but he pulls a wheelchair up for you to rest in. It's been difficult since you contracted weave rot some time ago. You've progressed to the point that it's difficult to move, and your body just doesn't work the way it should. After magic left, and then the medicines couldn't affect you anymore, and now you just are waiting for the inevitable at this point. He takes you outside to a nearby pond.
I appreciate you doing this for me.
No problem, friend. I know all those years of, you've been there and helping us and helping the others on the team for so long that this is the least I could do to return the favor.
Why are you living in this place in particular?
Well, it's where my mother raised me, and I just, after she left, I stayed here.
Have you taken care of many like me in this way?
I do my best to take care of everyone like you. Like I said, it's the least I can do for the sacrifices you make for us.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, I appreciate it as well. Probably more than anybody, I can understand the troubles you're going through right now. And trust me when I say that while it's rough right now, and it will get better for you. I'm living proof of it. He kind of points back to himself and kind of runs his hand down as to present his body as the proof itself.
Are you saying that there's another life after death?
I don't really know that it's so much another knife as a second chance.
And am I going to be able to get a second chance?
Oh, you already have the gift, sir. You feel your you feel your eyes getting heavy again. Even though you just woke up from a nap, you're clearly going back into yet another one, except this time you feel it. This time you understand it. This is the one. This is the moment where, when you shut your eyes, you will not open them back up. As your vision slowly fades, you see Nox kneel down in front of you, and he places his hand on your shoulder. He just says, "I'll see you in a bit, friend." Your vision goes black. To you, feels like almost no time passes. Your nap was quite pleasant. You open your eyes again. You're back on that same shore. You haven't moved. Only you're not in a wheelchair. You're sitting on a bench. Your sickly gray skin once again shows strange youth to it. And as you're inspecting this oddity, you notice on the back of your hand, the number's 222. You hear from behind you. "Well, hey there, mister! It's nice to see you!" And as you turn to inspect the sound, you find a young boy, can't be more than 8, sandy blonde hair, blue, the bluest eyes you've ever seen. And his hair is just an absolute mess. He's a young elf.
It was good.
He walks up to you and says, "Well, it's nice to meet you, mister. I'm Nox."
It's nice to meet you too.
And as he introduces himself, that strange sense of nostalgia just overwhelms you as you realize you're once again talking to your friend. "Don't just sit there and do nothing. Come on, let's go have fun. Let's play."
What do you want to play?
Just anything.
Hide and seek?
That sounds fantastic. Who wants to be the hider and the seeker? I'm a pretty good hider and a pretty good seeker.
I'll let you go hide. I'll count down.
Okay, fantastic. You ready?
Yeah.
All right.
I'll close my eyes and start counting.
Okay.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ready or not, here I come.
No signs of him anywhere. The two of you play hide and seek for the remainder of the afternoon. And then he kind of informs you that after you guys are done playing, he will come up to you and he will touch your hand. He'll go, "Keep an eye on this. It's to tell you when you become like Big Me."
Well, what does that mean?
Well, you see, it takes a while for the womb to process. And this is basically your number. You know how when you go to the post office, you have to pull out a little tab and it's a little number and you have to stand there and wait? Same basic idea. Only you don't get a piece of paper that's on the back of your hand.
Okay.
I just wanted to let you know, you've looked at it a couple of times now, so I figured I'd explain why you had that weird tattoo. As you guys continue to spend the day with each other, eventually he will run off, go on about his life. And then you will go on about your life. And the days will pass, the weeks will pass, the months will pass. Occasionally, the number goes down. But not every day. Only occasionally, it goes down. And the boy will visit you occasionally, and you guys will play more hide-and-seek or whatever game you guys fancy on that particular day. He doesn't come every day, but most days. And you spend your other days exploring the area. You look out into the ocean, always has a beautiful, calm seas, never bad weather. This world is effectively perfect. And then one day, you're sitting there at that same location you were when you first met Nox. And you feel a burning sensation on your hand. And you look down, and the number is rapidly dropping. And all of a sudden, you hear the boy run up. Mister, something terrible is happening!
What's happening? What happened?
I don't know! The outside world is angry! We need to hurry, we need to go!
Go where?
Oh, out of here! We need to get you to the other side quickly! We need to get to some of my other friends. Maybe they can help us.
I'm not understanding what you're trying to say. Like, what's happening?
Look! And he points off to, the distance, and you see a growing shadow coming, and it's going towards you as the trees themselves seem to begin to wither and die.
So, where do we go? What do we do?
We go to my home! And
lead the way.
So you guys run, and he eventually takes you to his home, which is the place you first met. And as you run inside of it, there's no door. You guys both just run into the tree. It seems to be a portal of some kind, and he takes you inside into the tree. And then your vision goes black.
Are you hurt?
No, I feel all right after what V did.
Oh, my poor friend. And yep. I massage his shoulders.
Massage the bone.
Left. And you guys see him massaging Benedict's shoulders, and the zombie is just moaning.
I'm not sure he has muscle left, and I'm saying this like to both Grier and No. I don't know if he's getting weirder by the day.
That's saying a lot. He started pretty weird.
Yeah. I think if we look around, I don't want to sort of rush us, especially in this environment. I think if we look around and find some place of shelter, we can take a rest. I can play something to help us along. But I say we should be tip top shape. I don't want to sort of half ass anything right now after what we just went through.
That's surprisingly responsible coming from you.
I was in the air and then I went somewhere else. I don't want that to happen again.
Yeah, you shot yourself, didn't you?
I did.
He did not shoot himself.
You don't have to make me feel better, Grier. I shot myself. That thing has never been good to me.
I mean, that's why you gave it to No.
Yes. Hopefully he'll have better luck
this time.
Well, okay, fine, sure. I didn't shoot myself.
You didn't. You just got Humpty Dumptied all over the ground.
So I just reach. I'm gonna look around to see if there's any structure that looks decently put together relative to, you know, what's going on around here, to see if we can hide there safely.
I bring out the bloody version of the marionette. That looks like me. I'm like, would you like a companion?
hold on to that. Rain check. And I'm just like, looking at it with one closed eye.
Its body stays in place as I hold it, but the head turns towards me, and I look at it, I just shrug.
I think it's best if you keep that. I'm in a weird headspace right now, and I don't know if I can handle that right now. You see tears welling up.
Okay, do a perception check for me.
14.
All right. As you fight back these tears of terror, you look around and you wander a bit, but you do eventually come across a building that, while is still mostly destroyed, there is a particular room that is somewhat intact. It's a two-story building, so the roof is gone, but the second floor is still mostly there. It has four walls and a ceiling, at least as good as you're gonna get in this place.
I sort of peek my head out of the structure towards the group. Guys, I think this is gonna do okay. If we wanna take a rest, if you wanna take a breather.
It'll do, at least the moon's out. Come on, no, Gaaraa, you hungry?
I suppose I should nourish myself.
Does your friend need nourishment too? Actually, don't answer that. I don't want to know.
Why did you ask that?
I don't want to know. It just kind of left my mouth, and then I thought of it after. I don't want to know.
Are you hungry?
I feel a bit peckish, yeah, but I'm not sure it's going to do any good if I eat anything.
He doesn't eat anything for the moment.
Good.
For the moment.
That's fine. I'll live with that for now.
Damn.
And I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but we only have enough water for one more day. Which is why we're going to the Grove.
Yeah, well, yeah, yep. Yeah, that's the mission. We need water. Hopefully something that we can possibly purify.
If we need to, we'll see. Maybe the Grove is miraculously intact?
I mean, of all the places in Dreval, I would hope the Grove would have some semblance of what it was, hopefully.
Although, I'm trying to remember, V, when we used the looking glass last time, weren't there like a bunch of bodies on spikes?
Yeah, there was. And you looked through it and you freaked out. What did you see? You didn't really elaborate.
It wasn't important. You couldn't do anything. There's just some headless horseman who wanted to kill us.
Oh.
Okay. What now?
Okay.
Well, not kill. Maybe not you kill me, but.
I wonder if this thing works, and I pull it out of my bag. I wonder if it works here. Like, can we?
Like in reverse.
In reverse, yeah. Can we see what's happening on the other side?
You can try, but
I'm not gonna do it because.
Are we just skipping over this headless horseman thing, or?
Well, no. We're gonna. This is loosely related.
Headless horseman isn't important.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull out this sort of monocle-looking thing. Does anybody want to?
Anything headless? I'll use it, but just for a quick statement, anything headless that's still moving is very important.
Have you looked at where we are? Do you remember what we just fought?
They had heads.
This is I mean.
But do you remember how it extended? Did it have an extendo spine? How did it do that?
Nah. Magic.
You think mysteriously amorphous forms that can just extend 15 feet longer than they are less disturbing than something without a head moving around? Have you ever met a chicken in real life?
Have you ever met something that removing its head doesn't kill it?
Now I have.
Exactly. Besides what you've just told me, I have never met something where removing its head does not kill it.
Chickens.
Well, no, that they do die. just they like to make sure to make you feel bad about it first.
Wait, chickens don't die when you cut their heads off?
If you do it wrong.
Oh my god. Does anybody want to take a shot at this thing?
Yeah, sure, why not?
I hand it over to Nil. I'm also going to unattune to it.
Okay.
You know what? You hold on to that. You might find better use, and you might be less freaked out.
You just keep giving me stuff, man.
It's what I do. Does anybody want my loot? No, I'm kidding. I would never give away this thing.
All right. So, V, remove the Gem of Seeing. No, add the Gem of Seeing.
Yes.
Speaking of which, what did V play for the Song of Rest?
A new song that I heard. It's called Stay.
How do I use this thing? And I kind of wave the Gem of Seeing back and forth.
You put it up to your eye and you speak the command word.
Which is?
Sight beyond sight. I mean, that's what I use. I don't know if it's different for you, but.
All right. Guess I'll try this little doodad out.
Okay.
Sight beyond sight, I say as a question.
As you do, two little bladed wings come flying yeah. out from the side and wrap around your eyes.
What the f-
And you see the world as it could be. The first thing you notice is that it appears to be in slow motion. But you see Durval. And as you look around, you see fires. That's the first thing you notice. There is fire everywhere. The sky is thick with smoke. You look up and you can see the Acheron and the other warships that were guarding the city are currently embattled with the clearly enemy airships above the city. As you look in the street around you, it is littered with bodies.
By the gods. We really need to get back.
Is everything okay?
No. If we don't hurry back, there's not going to be anything to go back to.
What?
I don't even...
There's fire everywhere and corpses all over the streets.
Okay, all right. Nobody panic. Nobody panic, okay? Nobody... Look, maybe that's not in real time. Maybe that's something maybe from the past, or...
There's no way. It's the city as I remember it. As if it, like I said, it could be same day, could be next day. Not much time has passed.
Okay.
But everything's moving slow.
Okay, so, all right. So let's get to the Grove. Let's find some supplies. And then we need to find the next beacon, crystal thing. And we need to get back.
As you're observing this, and you're kind of panicking, your heart is starting to race, your throat starts to feel scratchy, and your left leg starts to burn.
Fuck's on my... God damn, my leg!
What? Ah! There's nothing on your leg.
You doing all right there, buddy?
Am I standing in the fire?
No, it feels like it's coming from inside.
Take your leg out of the fire, dickhead.
That's what I was asking, man.
Yeah. Alright.
Gaaraa's probably super interested, though.
He's immediately there. Boom! You roll up your left leg, and it's currently covered in a massive rash. And you can see what appears to be some kind of mold or something coming out and out of it.
What the fuck?
Get it off. Get off.
I hear you gagging. I start gagging. What's happening back there?
Don't look.
Gaaraa tries to.
No, I think you have to take your pants off. We're going to have to get this off of you.
I literally ripped them bitches off so fast.
Okay, well, you're pantsless now. But the rash is there. The rash is...
How far up my leg does it go?
Your leg is basically covered. It's primarily focused, it appears to be kind of on your quads, mostly.
No, that's too high for comfort, man.
I've never done anything like this. No? What's your preference? Do you want me to use a sword and, like, scrape it off, or do you want me to heat up the blade and burn it?
Let's burn it, burn it.
All right.
Can you play something soothing, please?
stop right, gagging.
Grier's heating up the short sword in the fire in one of the heaters.
You're close for comfort. You're close for comfort.
Me and Noah are just gagging.
I cover the marionette's eyes.
And then once the blade's hot, she's going to start using it on the leg to try and burn the mold off.
Okay. All right. So you do the mold comes off, and as you do, you see it, and you scrape across the skin to pull it off, and it comes off fairly easy. But the pus comes kind of behind it and begins to ooze down his leg. But the rash does not. The mold comes off, but the rash stays.
I need this leg. I need this. Gaaraa, can you do anything?
Gaaraa, what do you have?
I'll try. I just, like, study it intently. See if it looks familiar or if I can identify it.
Do a medicine check.
Hell yeah, Gaaraa. Take control of that leg. Necromancy the fuck out of it.
Oh my god, he has one necromancy leg.
Oh, fuck.
He looks like he's got a really gross rash, man.
Yeah. Hurry up.
All right, so pour it on.
So I'll
start towards the top.
Yeah, I aim towards and then let it trickle down.
Oh,
down
his sexy. All
right.
You gotta rub it in too.
Furiously start scrubbing it in.
I use one finger to like kind of like rubbing it in like
Fortnite. Mm-hmm.
Like,
and then now you can hear the music that I'm playing begin to turn into like jazz music.
Somehow there's the sound of a saxophone.
I'm playing Careless Whisper.
Alright. As you pour this healing potion on him, you note that it feels nice. Like
the potion or Gaaraa rubbing it?
The rash temporarily stops itching and then is kind of slowly coming back.
If it's worth anything, it's a superior potion.
Why?
You only use a basic for this kind of shit.
So it's okay. It's all right.
Oops.
The label's wrong. He got it from Strixhaven.
Yeah, exactly. But no, it would not have helped.
I've got nothing. V, can you think of anything?
I don't know what it looks like.
It's just a rash at this point. I got rid of the mold.
I don't have anything. I mean, I can try healing word on it.
It's worth a shot.
I'm gonna close my eyes, but like open them periodically until I get to nose the rash. I'm just gonna start singing at it, because that's how I cast healing word.
Rash, go away.
No, do you have any roll healing word?
How does that work?
No, that's V.
Yeah.
V rolls it.
Apparently, well, shit, I cast it at third level, because that's the only slot that I have left.
Oh, dear.
This leg. Yeah.
11? Wow.
Okay, you heal for 11 points of damage, but the rash doesn't change.
Well, that gives me 2 hit points.
Is anything? Is it working? I can't see.
No.
Okay, didn't work. I'm walking back. I'm walking back away.
Your speed's reduced by 5, but you can walk on it.
Yeah, you doing all right there?
I can walk on it. Yeah, somebody help me get my pants back on.
I nod to the marionette, and the marionette walks over.
Gives you your pants.
Well,
guess we'll see how the rest of the day goes.
If anything changes, you let Grier or Gaaraa know. We're here for you.
Did you use a we in that statement while excluding yourself?
Mm-hmm, I did.
If sure. I feel and move even another inch up, I'll take the leg off myself. I don't even care at this point. It's too close for comfort.
You have a sword. How are you going to take it off?
I got a dagger. You don't understand.
You're gonna You're going to sever your femoral artery and bleed out.
Well, I'm going to sever my will to live.
That's not
if
good.
If I don't.
And also, you'd have to manage to saw through your own femur, which is the densest bone in the body. I don't think you're going to do that with a dagger. You'd blunt the blade.
Do a medicine check for me, since you're throwing med terms out.
You're going to have to cut through your diddly what's-it thingy.
She doesn't know what the fuck. She read it somewhere.
You're saying things. I need you to start making up words.
It's like, keeps glancing down at a book she has, like...
No, she's trying to remember a book she read. You know, and then there's the gurgle nerve, and that'll just make everything worse if you touch that.
I mean, these sound correct?
There's worse things to lose, okay?
I mean, severing the gurgle nerve sounds pretty bad.
As you get closer to the grove, you get to the edge of the grove, you do note that portions of the road are lined with headless corpses. Okay.
Hey guys, why do you think there's a bunch of headless corpses on spikes here and not everywhere?
Well, that is the question, isn't it?
Like, who did this?
Would rather not find out.
Where are those heads?
Also a valid question. There's a real headless theme going on here that I wouldn't expect in a district like this.
Well, maybe it gets better the further we go in. Maybe it's just out here.
I feel like that kind of thought has never worked for us, but let's go ahead and try it again.
Like I said, we need to be quick, because whatever is doing this and whatever track that is, I don't want to find out.
You reach the edge of the grove, and you see the what was once a vibrant place is now nothing more than death. All of the trees, all of the grass. No greenery before you. Just bare nothingness. But the corpses stop at the edge of the grove. They do not go into the grove. They stop there. As you make your way further into the grove, eventually you note a figure sitting on a bench.
Rear.
Yeah?
What is that?
I don't know. I mean, that looks like somebody.
I think someone should check it out. Gaaraa?
Oh, me? Okay, I suppose.
Yeah, you like to make friends, right?
It could be friendly. If it's friendly, you made another friend. If it's not, we're right here.
I do like friends.
I mean, you've made plenty since you've been here, so.
So, the marionette was, it was riding on my shoulders before, so I just take him and kind of, like, pull him in front of me, like a weird guard of sorts, and I slowly approach.
Okay. Sending the people with poor vision into...
I'm going in there.
So, as you go in, you get closer and you notice that the small figure is sitting on a bench. This bench is oddly intact, and you see two little legs just kind of swinging back and forth, and it's just kind of looking at the ground right now.
Size of a marionette, perhaps?
No, the size of a small child.
Nope.
Hello. Are you a friend?
The figure turns to you. And immediately jumps up and starts like bounding towards you.
Oh god.
Oh fuck. Why did I hear?
It looks like it's gonna go give him a hug. It's a friend, Grier. I think we're okay.
Yeah, friend. I'm a friend. We're friends.
Friend. What is my new friend's name?
So as he runs up, you see a small boy, can't be more than 8, sandy blonde hair. He has the bluest eyes you've ever seen. The hair's kind of messy. And he's, oh! Well, I'm not, Gaaraa!
Oh, the fuck?
How do you know my name?
Well, why wouldn't I know your name? You've been helping out with the Alehounds recently.
Oh. Are you?
I'm not. You...
Nox? Is that you?
Yeah, it's me.
Why are you so tiny?
This is what I look like on this side.
Oh. And on the other side?
The pygmy's over there right now.
And it's like, you know, that meme with the gears in the air? Like, that's like Gaaraa, like, calculating things in his head.
Can we see the child from where we are, or are we too far away?
You could, right now, you just see Gaaraa talking to a small shadow. But he seems to be having a pleasant conversation right now.
And I turn around and wave to them. Friend! Nox!
Nox?
He just said Nox?
Nox?
Nox!
What?
Huh? Are you sure?
Yes! I like nod excitedly. And I'm like shaking the marionette.
Oh, holy shit. Grier? I think it is really him. Hello?
But how? This is what you looked like before.
And he runs past Gaaraa and runs over to you guys.
Hey! I'm still very on guard.
He leaps at you.
Hey, guy! Hey, Nox! Fist bump.
And I kind of fall. I fall. Did over you drop? With the lack no. of support.
Yeah.
I'm clapping. Friend.
Nox, is that really you?
Of course, it's me.
How? Why?
Well, I'm here. We need to fix things.
Yeah, we do. Yeah. But how are you here right now? Did you get sucked in too, or?
No, I'm always here.
Oh. What? What you mean? You're always here.
Well, I help guide the souls back.
From here?
It's my duty as the first.
Oh, well, I look over at Grier. That's something, huh?
The first what?
Well, the first of the Warforged.
And this is the look you're going with here? That's the one you chose?
This, Uncle V, this is me. And you, as you guys are looking at him, you start getting brief glimpses of memories. The past life that you see in your dreams. And the boy standing in front of you is the boy that you saw, not only in front of Nox's place interacting with Harrow, but it was the boy that was running through the yard behind the house. It was the boy that was standing at the on the steps of the manor when you were outside of Mariani and the attack. It's the boy that has appeared in every single one of your dreams. This is him before he was a Warforged.
Nox, are you saying that when you became a Warforged, part of your soul stayed here?
Yes.
And that's this part?
That's this part, yes.
Oh boy. Nox. Do you have any idea what's going on? I mean, do you just stay here in the grove, or what's left of it?
Yeah. Yeah, I stay here and I... Oh, what? No. I can't believe I forgot this. And Nox runs back to where he started. He just like takes off.
Whoa.
Wait.
Did he follow? Chase after the kid.
Yeah, let's go. Let's go.
And he runs towards that weird rock formation. But as you guys get closer, you note that it's not a rock formation. And Grier and V, you've seen this before. You see a large fungal pod, of large mushroom pod, one that you had seen before in a past dream.
Nope, mushrooms. Nope, don't do mushrooms.
Is that what I think it is?
Pretty sure.
Okay.
Which means we're about to see the birth?
Yep. That's exactly what I was thinking.
First time seeing it in this life.
And all of a sudden, Nox just starts knocking on the fungal pod. He's like, "It's time to wake up! It's time to wake up!" You guys see as a hand just erupts out from the pod.
Oh,
Gaaraa's mind's blown.
You can make friends without dead bodies?
Most people do, Gaaraa.
Bobby, please describe the Warforged version of your character.
Pretty basic. He's kind of tallish, 6'2". You'll see, I guess since he's just born, he won't have the metal plating on, so he'll just be like mostly, you know, wood and greenery, I guess. And and he has dark green eyes. Oh, not like bright green eyes. Yeah. And he'll have the number 222 etched on his the back of his hand, right? The same hand that he punched the wall with, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
Well,
hello.
Welcome.
Me, right?
Yeah. welcome to the world, little guy.
Little guy?
He was just born. World? I don't know how this works.
What world is this?
That's how birth works.
This is exactly how birth works. Babies punch their way out.
Oh, God.
It's like the Chappelle Show skit.
My poor mother.
Remember how I said something went wrong?
Yes.
This is wrong.
So, what happened?
I don't know, but we need to fix it. Something happened and the tree stopped. Well, the tree stopped working, and it started pushing people out of it. It started pushing everybody out of it.
What do you mean it started pushing everyone out? What does that mean?
Well, when you die and you're destined to become a Warforged, you go into the tree and you live there in the tree until it is your time. And then you are reborn in the normal world, but something happened and the tree just started ejecting everything, almost like something was hurting it.
Like a defensive response?
I don't know. It's never done this before.
Well, there was an attack on the other side.
I know. Big Me is fighting right now.
I mean, we don't mean to overwhelm you with all this, but we sort of need all the help we can get. Warforged or reborn. Do you remember anything from your past?
Or how about starting with what's your name?
That too. Either or, be fine.
Everything is hazy right now. I'm not sure at the moment.
Right. I mean, he was born today, literally. Yeah. We'll give you some time. Come with us to the tree. We're gonna go get some water. We'll get you some clothing, and we'll get you fixed up.
You do eventually get to a source of water. There's several ponds throughout the grove. And as you walk up towards the water, you look in and there is a strange violet glow coming underneath. He like reaches down in there and as he does, he pushes his hand through it, and you can actually see what was once, you thought, clear water seems to become foggy as he moves his hand through it, and like reaches through to move the sand down below, and you see that he uncovers small crystals. Oh no. This is what's hurting it.
The crystals?
These aren't supposed to be here. These aren't normal.
What are they?
The same ones that are used by it everywhere.
Well, it's okay. That's what we're here for. We'll help you figure it out.
The vines around him, around his arms, will kind of run down and kind of go into the soil, and they'll begin to bloom. And you'll see the ground kind of in the water kind of like shimmer and shudder a bit as he seems to be trying to push out whatever these crystals are. But as he does, you will notice a series of mushrooms begin to kind of come out with that, in addition to all of the little crystals that are coming out. It's not gonna let me do this. It's getting mad at this, whatever it is. And as
it's sentient,
is happening, you hear a shriek. So as this thing is screeching at you, No just immediately knocks two arrows, fires them off, and it just kind of flops over dead.
Oh.
Nice work, No. You got that trigger finger.
That was hostile, yeah. Sorry, I'm just... I don't... That wasn't friendly, was it?
I'm pretty sure it wasn't.
I didn't even see this happen.
He was looking the other way.
Yep.
It ate one of the people. And he's saying that, and he appears to be holding back tears. One of the people that was housed within the tree, it consumed him and turned him into that.
So you mean the crystals use somebody's soul to make that? When that was waiting?
Yes. It did what the tree did. What the tree does.
But it made them into a monster?
It does look that way.
Well, that is deeply disturbing.
We need to get to the main tree. I need to figure out a way to solve this. I don't know that trying to clear them from out here is going to help. We need to get
the source.
We need to get the streams back up and running again. But before you stands the stands the great tree, and you can see spirits wandering around the area all around you, and the number of crystals is noticeable here. You don't need to dig around, like, you can see them in the water.
Are these the spirits you're supposed to take back, Nox? Or
there's yes. a lot of them here.
Yeah, these are all people that were in the tree.
Are they cool, or?
They were destined to become Warforged. They're on the river. Oh, they're going to cross. They're not going to be able, they're not going to be able to be reborn. They're going to die. He starts to panic a little bit.
Nox. Hang on. They won't if you do what you have to do. We'll help you.
Okay. I will do it. I will do it, and I will hopefully get this thing fixed. Just be prepared for whatever happens once I start.
What's supposed to happen? That information could be useful.
Well, it's just like what Mom would always do. You know, you've seen Mom do it when she would prepare the areas, a grove for herself. It would go under her command again, and she would prepare various things in the area during the war, but generally, it just made it a pleasant place to stay.
Grier taps the side of her head and goes, We don't have all those memories.
Oh. Well, let's just say it makes this place mine again.
You focus on that, and the rest of us will take care of anything else that happens while you're working.
Do you need anything from us? You need us to do anything to make sure this happens?
If anything bad happens, just make sure it doesn't get to me.
I just look at everyone.
First gas, second. Got it.
We'll make sure you're safe.
We protect our friends.
Okay. Nox, once again, begins to cast, only this time the act is much more involved. He begins to kind of prepare a magical circle in the dirt around him. And then you watch as the vines begin to, on his arms, begin to expand and trace out that magical circle, and then they begin to bloom. And as they bloom, there is a slight bioluminescence to the flowers, a light blue color. The ground itself does not appear to necessarily return to life so much as once again begin to rumble and move, as it appears that Nox is gaining control of the area directly around him. And this continues to reverberate out until it reaches some of the water that's nearby. There's quite a bit around you, actually. And as it ripples out, and you see these crystals begin to emerge, and then vines will come out and begin to crush them one by one. These crystals, as they come out of the ground, just crushing them. This is emanating further and further out. And as this is happening, you start noticing multiple mushroom caps beginning to emerge from the ground around you. I need you all to once again roll initiative.
Tiny Nox is adorable. Yep.
Oh
yeah. No.
So here's his main picture.
Oh, am I not in?
Oh,
Tiny Nox.
What a sweet young lad.
Aww. No, you're up. What do you do first?
Right, so the magic user, I'm gonna take a shot at him.
Okay. Which one? This one?
The one that's across the water towards the actual big tree.
Okay.
East.
Grier, do you want to pilot Siren? Jesus Christ.
Holy. Oh. See, again.
Game over.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's just roll that d4 real quick before I make another attack. Okay. I'm going to shoot at him again.
Okay.
I don't like scary spells.
Okay.
What is happening?
All right.
To be fair, he has a plus 10.
I do have a plus 10.
That's true.
Yeah.
And I assume I beat his natural AC.
Oh, you do. Yes.
Let me pull out my blaster.
Yeah, so I started blasting.
I started blasting.
So what happened? I just started blasting.
Meanwhile, I'm going to poke him with burning.
Yeah.
29 points of damage in a single turn.
Fucking wild.
Time to shine, BB.
Well, since I was just born.
You retain all of your memories from your previous life.
Okay. Well, I'm still a little hazy, you know. I don't know how to do anything at this moment, like this particular moment.
Mm-hmm.
So, let's see. So I'm just going to, like, stand by and try and protect Nox.
Okay. You're just going to hang out with him, make sure nothing gets him?
Yeah, just
for now. So you're holding an action?
Punch something if it gets close? Or cast a spell if it gets close?
Punch something if it gets close.
Okay.
It's fine because Noah's just going to wipe the fucking floor with these things.
Hey. So. What have I told you about having faith?
Yep.
It's going to be yes.
Don't do it. No, don't do it.
It's going to be oh,
you'll
yes.
ruin everything.
I'll start rolling ones.
Okay.
That's my job tonight.
Yes. Uh-oh. We miss so much lore because of you, Grier.
Three ones.
And as Nox continues the spell, it radiates out further, and it basically engulfs this tree. And you see the flowers around it and you try to bloom, but then the earth itself seems to rise up around it. Like, and you see not necessarily a mushroom creature come out at this point, but the earth forms into a very, it goes up about 15 to 20 feet in size, and then it begins to take the form of some sort of hulking creature. You see massive arms come out from it. The fists themselves are as large as your head. It's leaned forward, its head posture, and there are kind of root-like spines going off its back, and it has what appears to be some sort of enclosed rib cage, but again, it looks like roots.
I'm gonna need you to calm down a little bit. I just got some pointy sticks that I want.
Started.
Ah. Oh fuck. Okay.
Where is it?
Yep.
Oh.
B, you're in charge of that one.
Guys. Something came out of the tree's butthole. Look at the top of the tree.
V. You are near it.
I see this thing emerge, and I'm going to run towards Grier.
As you do,
a
bunch of roots, you don't get to move, as a bunch of roots come out and begin to entangle around you, they grab and kind of choke you. You take 16 points of bludgeoning damage as they crush you, and you are currently restrained. Grier, also, you see these roots come out and take a hold of you. You take 11 points of damage as you are now both bound. By this creature coming out. And then as it moves forward slightly, you see puffs of spores erupting around it as it is making its way towards you. And it stops about right there.
Guys, help!
Nox continues his work. He just kind of closes his eyes and concentrate, knowing that he must complete his task, even though this is coming.
My speed is zero.
You can try to get out of the vines.
There are physical vines. I'm going to try, yes.
Okay. How are you going to try to get out of the vines?
I'm just
going to,
with whatever strength V has, which isn't much, I'm going to try and rip my arms out of this.
You can't dance your way out?
Nope, not in this moment.
Do an athletics check for me.
13.
You are unable to remove the vines. You try and they just crush down further on you.
Guys, I'm stuck. I'm panicking now.
He will see that No really fucked up his friend. And No, you will see a cloud of different insects just start flying around you, coming at you. I need you to make a constitution saving throw as these things attach to your body.
Okay. Oh no.
Come on now.
Oh no.
Come on, you can do it.
You can do it, I believe.
You had too much faith in me earlier. Stop it. You can't say those words.
All right,
it's the seven you rolled earlier. Your first roll.
Yeah.
These things attach and claw at your body. They begin to eat it. You could feel the little stingers going in. You take 6 points of poison damage, but you are poisoned.
Shit.
And while poisoned in this way, you subtract 1d4 from any attack roll.
Oh.
So please mark your character so as poisoned.
He just wanted to balance me a bit. Gotcha.
It's like I've had enough.
Yeah.
So
Gaaraa, help!
I get into line of sight with this guy.
Mm-hmm.
And then I point at him and I cast Mind Sliver.
Okay.
What do I need to do for that? So you need to do an intelligence saving throw.
And she's gonna fail.
Okay. And then so you take 2d6.
Okay.
7.
Okay.
And then you have to subtract 1d4 from the next saving throw you make before.
Okay.
Okay, so then it's Benedict's turn.
Mm-hmm.
I say, help Grier! Can he do strength?
He can. Now, also, there are physical vines. I just want to point that out. You can do a strength throw if you want. Let's see, what is Benedict's strength? Plus one.
Okay. Come on, Benedict. Five.
He attempts to free Grier of what is happening, and he is unable to.
Okay, one more guy. Where do I see him again? Oh, Blunt's the marionette. Does he have a dagger like me, or?
No, he's just a little punchy. He's just a little creepy ball that's running around right now.
Can I give him my other dagger?
Oh God! I mean, you can't.
Lock
sure.
a doll a knife.
And send it towards Grier.
Never give a doll a knife.
Grier's in a bad spot right now. She got a zombie and a little doll with a knife.
Yo, Bones, I feel like you and Archon sat down. I feel like you and Archon sat down. You're like, we need to add creepy dolls to our campaigns.
Mini Gaaraa, take this dagger and try to free Grier. And so he goes here.
Grier's probably freaking out right now. What the fuck?
I was like, if it comes up behind her, she can't even see it.
Yeah.
She gets stabbed in the leg.
All right, you can like make an attack roll against the roots.
Okay.
I feel like there'd be a creepy tiny little laugh behind you.
There you go.
Damage?
Yeah.
Come on. Okay.
You begin cutting these. You get like one of the roots cut, but there's still a bunch there.
Oh my god. Okay.
Which root? It's important.
just the one now next to his ankle or her ankle because he's tiny.
He's tiny.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Grier and V.
Oh fuck.
The roots begin dragging you.
Oh no.
Closer to it.
Oh no.
Oh no.
B.
Oh no.
I need you to make a wisdom saving throw.
Oh no.
Last time we were in the tornado.
Hey,
this
you're wise.
Time it's
I have faith. I have faith.
That is a 10.
You are now I don't know why this.
Yeah, well,
you're terrified. I'm already. You are now frightened.
Yep.
And you can't do anything about it.
Already yeah. knew that.
But as you look upon this thing, you see this creature in front of you, and you begin to have hallucinations of it in all types of even worse forms.
Oh boy.
You got this. I got faith.
Yeah, I guess we're gonna try and break out.
Okay. How are you breaking out?
I doubt she can do anything with her sword, so she's gonna. She's just gonna try and rip him off.
Okay, go ahead.
What do you want me to roll?
Athletics check.
That's a 16.
All right,
let's go.
You are able to free yourselves from these vines as they grasp onto you. These roots. You just kind of tear them off, like Hulk out.
Go fuck this. She's sitting there going, that sucked. We're gonna activate the Crimson Rite.
Okay. Take your damage.
Why do I always roll so high for myself?
Right.
Ouchie. That hurts.
It do be hurt. And I'm going to move here.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll pilot her. She is gonna try and get to V.
Okay. That does sound like something she would do.
V is silently screaming.
Oh, I can't move her. She's right there.
Okay.
What's and she's going to try and free V.
Okay. I need you to make a wisdom saving throw as you run into the cloud of spores.
Oh, no.
Damn it, Siren.
Oh, God.
As Siren enters the cloud of spores, she also begins to see the hallucinations, and this creature gets more and more terrifying. Siren is frightened of what has emerged.
Guys, we're in a bad spot right now.
She's just trying to free V.
Okay. How are you trying to free him?
She's got a big sword.
Okay. You can swing away, hack at it. Disadvantage, though. As you're hacking at it while terrified of.
Yeah, it's plus 7 with a greatsword.
Yeah, I think you also have a plus 7.
Yep, so I'll just roll that.
Yeah, just roll you. So and 10. You notice as she's swinging, her blade reacts, and you see necrotic energy begin to eat out through the roots, which is enough. And V is now free from the roots that are.
Fuck yeah.
That are covering him.
No, I said I thought V was into bondage.
I mean, I haven't revealed that part of my story yet. Slow burn.
I was saying, he hasn't said that yet.
It was just an assumption.
Yeah, she's going to face step away then.
Okay. Where to?
She's going to face step up to that guy. So.
Who's that guy?
Yeah, I'm going to ping him. She has just enough to get up to him.
Okay, yeah. And then I guess you're going to swing at him, so swing away.
Yep. Pull that up. I'm guessing that does not hit.
That just barely hits.
Okay.
What is happening?
10 damage.
All right. Which is just enough. And she cleaves this down.
Ooh.
Fuck yeah.
The big guy in the middle is going to take a legendary action.
Oh, fucking hell, man. We don't have any spell slots. We did long rest. What are you doing?
Bro, you have never used your Ring of Evasion.
I haven't. I didn't need to roll a dex.
You better start taking.
Taking what?
Start looking through your inventories, better guys. Figuring out what you have. Start using all those things I gave you. You notice a mushroom begins to grow over here. This thing runs up to No, and it's screeching. I need Arnaald, No, and Gaaraa all to make Constitution saving throws.
Oof. Okay.
Oh no. No, No is on a downward spiral right now.
You said the cursed words.
Yeah. The seven is coming back to haunt you.
No, and Arnaald. You both take 7 points of thunder damage.
Thunder?
As this thing is screeching so heavily, it just compresses and your head begins to ache, and you are dazed until the end of the next round, which is this thing's turn.
Oh, God.
So, no. What are you doing?
I mean, I could still try and shoot him, yeah?
You can. It would be a disadvantage.
All right, cool. Yeah, why not? Let's throw my life away.
All right. Fire away.
Just have to say the curse words.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Roll a d4. See how bad that poison is affecting you.
Pretty bad.
Okay.
So that
miss. You, in fact, miss. Arnaald, you're up.
Help. Help us.
Help. Help.
Hey, Arnaald. Help.
Okay, so I will help. I will...
It's all coming back. It's all coming back it's to coming me back. Now.
I'm going to do a firebolt to... who's in more trouble?
The big guy. The big guy.
I'm in trouble.
No, V is in much more trouble.
Okay, so I'll... Oh, wait, where's V? Hold up.
Right in front of you.
Oh, this thing, with the big guy, okay.
Yep.
Oh, fine, I'll firebolt this brute.
Okay. Roll away.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. You're focused on Nox, and you try to firebolt this gargantuan creature, but in your attempts to... protect Nox, you're more focused on him and you miss. It just swings past this thing that is like 10 feet wide. Somehow you missed.
I'm real glad Nox has his eyes closed because we're embarrassing ourselves.
he talked to us up so much.
All right, and that's it for you. No bonus actions.
No, I'm dazed.
Oh, that's right. You are dazed.
He's trying to get used to his new body.
That's right.
Yeah.
Oh, no,
babe. Actually, yeah, so we got it. Actually, it's not until his turn. Grove Tender's up. V, you watch as he is, it just kind of like pushes you to the ground. It's like pushing you around right now. It playing with you.
Bullied. I'm getting bullied. Guys, I'm getting bullied.
While it's playing with you, Gaaraa, vines, or these roots erupt out from around you, grab you, and you are entangled. You take 11 points of bludgeoning damage as these roots crush you, and you are restrained.
Oh my god.
Nox has opened his eyes.
No, good.
And is continuing, he cannot ignore what is happening around him. He will use his reaction, and you will see as these roots take it, you know, you begin to bleed the wounds begin to open on you, and then you will see arcane stitches begin to seal the wounds, preventing 9 points of those damage.
Nice.
As it can't quite seal all the wounds up. Then Nox will also use his actual turn and temporarily pause the ritual. And again, these kind of like arcane strings will begin to go off of him, and one will land on V. And as it does, you see the world around you, as it's slapping you, and these arcane stitches come around you and kind of take into your sight, it begins to move slower. He also does this to Arnaald. So as these stitches come out, you both see the world move slower a bit. You will receive one additional bonus action on your next turn, which you can convert into an extra attack or cantrip if you do not have a bonus action.
Yep, we're using the shock grenade. Mm-hmm. That's also a DC 12.
21.
Shit.
So he's wise to what she's up to now, and he sees the grenade coming in, and you just see his big paw come and just swat it away as it's in flight.
There you go.
Okay.
So 9 damage.
Yep. And rough.
All right.
How do you want to do this? Right?
No.
No? Okay. Just making sure.
To be so lucky.
He's going to use a legendary action and throw a... you see him reach into his chest cavity and pop out some sort of growth that was inside, and then he's going to throw it in between all of you guys.
Oh, shit.
Oh, Lord.
I need you to all make a constitution saving throw.
Fine, all.
Bro, you and your constitution saving throws.
No! Arnaald, no, and Gaara.
All right, what other debuff am I stacking on here? Let's find out.
Gaara's resilient.
Gaara is resilient.
Yeah.
Bro, wizard.
As this thing bursts, you feel it begin to like burn your skin. You can feel your skin like dying away as the necrosis sets in. You take 15 points of necrotic damage.
Shit.
Gaara, you only take 7.
Okay.
That's half his hit points.
I'm waiting for the and part of this, though.
Yeah.
You have healing abilities. Use them next turn.
Yep. No, that was it for that thing.
Oh, thank goodness.
V, as you're running towards this thing, you see it also pull a growth off its body.
Oh, fuck's sake. Well, I ran here blindly because I rolled the D6 to see which direction I would run.
Yeah. Well, this is what you're seeing as you're running towards it. And then it throws it over you, also into the same batch of people.
Oh, God.
Oh, man.
Ain't no way in hell it has that good of an arm.
Oh, hold on.
I can't silver and barbs it, right?
No, because it's not an attack roll. He's throwing a grenade.
You know what you can do? You can silvery barbs if he succeeds on the constitution saving.
Yeah, you can. But yes, he does. He can't actually yeet it. He just makes it. It actually kind of it would land like... Character. Huh?
I said jokes on you guys. I have a backup character.
I don't.
Yeah.
Okay, we have one zombie.
I need you all Fennec to make shows up. Constitution saving throws.
Oh my god.
This is the easiest saving throw to make, by the way.
Wait, wasn't there something where I had to like do a D4 for my saving throws or something? Or was that just
on your attack rolls and ability checks?
You also
that's
have
the mites are.
You also have exhaustion, I think, now, right?
Hmm?
Yeah, so that's only a 13.
Yeah. So as this thing lands, let's see. God, no. Oh no.
Oh shit.
Oh no, God. How do I die?
You see a burst, another burst of spores come out.
Noah has not moved.
Noah, you take 13 points of poison damage as you inhale some of these. Arnaald and Gaaraa, you take 6. You feel, as you inhale it, you feel it eat away at the magic inside of you, only briefly, as you take the damage.
It's poison damage?
It's poison damage, yes. So...
If I'm resistant, what does that do?
So it's just half of that. So you take 3. You take 3 damage, yes.
Can you try and put me magically to sleep? I'm resistant to that.
Can it, please?
Oh, shit, I forgot to.
Or Minigara.
Benedict needs to help his master.
Yeah. I mean, the fucking knife-wielding fucking puppet.
Knife-wielding puppet is more competent so far.
I feel like, aside from Noah's initial attack, this knife-wielding puppet is doing work.
So I can have the knife-wielding puppet take the mushroom and chuck it at something?
The mushroom has been growing this entire time. It's actually quite large at this point.
You can try.
So yeah, you can try to stab it.
Okay, yeah, let's stab it.
I mean, you can cantrip against it. That is one of your things your dude can do.
I mean, but like, a mushroom doesn't have a mind. Can't mind sliver it, right?
What do you know?
All right, he's just gonna stab it.
Okay.
You know about this mushroom. You don't know shit.
Wait away.
You don't have a mind.
Oh, come on. I don't know.
You hit it. You feel it go into the mushroom.
Do work, little guy.
You carve this thing swings frantically, carving away at the mushroom.
Fucking Chucky.
Carves the name Gaaraa into the side of the mushroom.
But it does not seem to have slain it. It's doing damage to it, but it does not seem to have stopped it.
We're having a puppet solo a mushroom.
Just like visualizing this scenario.
Visually, this is hilarious.
It's insane.
Grier, you're up.
So, since this fight is going this way, preemptively, I'm just gonna healing surge.
Okay.
We are doing our literal strength.
I have literally not hit anything or even tried to yet.
I haven't done anything.
Because last time I was restrained, and this time I was like, I should heal myself.
I haven't done anything since the curse has been reactivated.
I am running around the battlefield.
Welcome to my...
Greg, you're not secretly immune to necrotic by some...
No.
No? Okay.
No.
I would like to take this time to polymorph in Ruh Roh, please. Thank you.
No, you were right. It is the mushrooms.
Hey guys, can we long rest here or
mid game? Just fucking long rest.
Mid fight, just fall asleep.
Hey, hostile dudes, give us like a few hours. We got a long rest. Thanks.
Give us 4 hours at least.
He's going to turn into. You're going to see it puff into a black cloud, and then a series of ravens come flying out.
Which one?
The Grove Tender, as he takes a legendary action.
Mm.
And he will reform. You watch as the ravens reform,
mm-hmm.
and he reappears right next to Nox.
No!
So all of these spikes come out. Grier, you see one of the mushrooms get hit with the spike. You get clipped on your ankle, but you manage to get out of the way as this is happening. Benedict also gets clipped. Gaaraa, you get a clean hit through your thigh. You take 7 points of piercing damage. Everyone else only takes 3. So this area is now difficult terrain.
Movement speed is halved here.
Movement speed is halved, and the spikes are active. Moving through this area will be dangerous.
If we make it 0.
You're just looking around and seeing how poorly this is going for everyone. Everyone's bleeding. Nox is struggling. She's gonna look down at her short sword and flip it over to the black side and look back up and activate Pandemonium.
Excellent.
I like the sound of it. What does it do?
The world around you, the world around you temporarily goes black, and then you see the what was once the dead floor seem to get a bit of life back as you take a temporary, you pull in a bit of Pandemonium here, a piece of the dark Feywild, and you hear the laughter of Fey creatures coming from all around you. So everyone else, you just see Grier disappear, and there's like a black dome around her right now. Roll your damage. It's your Hemocraft die times your proficiency profile,
And so. Then plus 4, so that's 12.
Yep. All right.
And then a DC 15 saving throw.
Yep. So you see the spell spore, the guy in front of you that's looking at you seems unaffected, but he does take the damage. But then the big guy seems to be looking around and taking notice of what is around him as you hear the laughter of the Fae everywhere. Gaaraa.
Okay.
Actually, Gaaraa, you're still restrained.
Yeah. So I'm
frightened.
Up in his face.
It is dragging you right now across the spikes.
Oh, wow.
As he's dragging you across these spikes, you're literally going, it is ramming you into them. As it gets closer, you take 12 points of piercing damage as it pulls you across them.
Yeah, fun.
Yep.
All right. He after becoming incapacitated, he's going to immediately use a legendary action.
He's a little angry.
That was a decision.
Why is there a rectangle?
What is this?
What is this?
I'm not over there, so I'm okay.
He will again dig his hands into the ground, and just like before, something will erupt from the earth, except this time. Actually, it's like that. Except this time, you see walls erupt. So, first, a structure of spiky roots come up, and then vines come out. I need all of you to make dexterity saving throws that are next to that thing.
No. Oh no. Oh,
do I get like uppercutted in the chin by the wall coming up?
17 for Siren.
17 for Siren.
Oh, I gotta do one more for Benedict.
Yep.
No, we're both fucked.
Okay. All of you that got hit, take 19 points of piercing damage as these walls just erupt through you. Also, they go into the air 20 feet.
Am I on top of the wall?
No, you get pushed back away. So anyone that was, so you would be now here. Let me move you guys to where you would be. Gaaraa is just where he is. Benedict is pushed out.
So does Siren take the full damage?
Siren takes half.
So Benedict does an undead fortitude, I believe.
Oh, so he's at 1 HP now instead of down?
Yes. Well, you got to do the constitution save.
Oh.
Oh wait, we could have used that for the fight theater.
Raise like down.
Yeah. Okay.
We're both down.
Oh dear.
I'll take shots at the guy right next to Grier.
Okay. That hits.
With a 14, it hits.
Sham.
Oh, with a 14, it misses.
Damn
it.
Okay. Oh, well.
That hits.
Okay.
Finish him.
Hmm. All right.
Hang on.
Nope.
It doesn't matter. He only had 9 HP left.
And I couldn't hit him 3 attacks.
Yep.
Hex transfers onto the big guy, by the way.
Okay.
Alright, cool. I'm gonna go ahead and Misty Step.
Okay.
To here.
Alright.
You're just going around kill stealing now? Is that what you're doing?
Of course.
What he's best at.
Cool. He's within 90 feet, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
So let's do a chromatic orb.
Okay.
Yeah.
That hits.
And I am doing... Can I pick which kind of damage? How do I do that?
You just say it.
Just tell me what you want.
Oh, okay. Let's do... Yeah, let's do eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Let's do lightning.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Nice.
That's a nice really spell. Good. I like that.
Yeah, chromatic orb is good.
20, 20, 22. On No, Fee, and Arnaald. As the roots come out and grab all of you.
Oh, fuck.
What?
Oh, man.
So, no, you take 9 points of bludgeoning damage as he grabs you. You are restrained. V.
Damn.
You take 13 points. Wow. These fucking, like, right on the edge
go off
here.
Fuck.
You're like, oh, they look like they might win this fight. Hang on.
let me change this.
No, I mean, that's legitimately what I'm rolling. I can't, no. I don't know what to say.
It's okay.
No, you take 22 points of damage.
Why'd you change it, bro? Hold up, why'd you change it?
I rolled okay, to I rolled slightly better, to I rolled like a badass and got a damn near max roll.
So you said fuck you.
Yeah, so
alright, I'm taking a nap.
Alright, I am going to bonus action healing word. That is my last spell slot. Bonus action healing word to Gaaraa.
Okay.
Ooh.
Wait, can I see him throw those spikes or no?
You can.
I can, okay.
It's just a field, it's just a very thick field of spikes. They're gotcha. About waist-ish high.
Okay, yeah, so I'm gonna bonus action healing word on Gaaraa for 9 points.
Okay.
I'm gonna swing at homeboy in front of me.
Okay. Get him.
Come on, V. 19?
That hits.
Get him, V.
9 points of damage.
And you run him clean through.
Oh, yeah.
I've had enough!
It's done!
So you feel this claw come across you. You take 15 points of slashing damage, and as you look down at the slashes, and you can see a rash forming as you fall to the ground.
Lovely.
You take 17 points.
And Grier's down.
Uh-oh.
He's going to try and vine 26.
Who is he mining?
Siren.
Fuck! No! That's everyone!
Oh.
That's literally everyone.
We're all binded right now.
The 3 people who are still conscious are all bound.
And everyone's pretty fucked up.
Not Siren.
B. You get dragged in. You take 3 points of piercing damage. You did.
All right.
You take 6 points of piercing damage as you make your way.
I get dragged all the way over there.
V. You lay on the ground in your unconscious state. You look around. You see something kind of appear off the side. It walks in from the shadow. And it just kind of walks up towards you. You can just kind of see its feet. And it kneels down next to you. Are we going to allow this to happen again? You hear your own voice speaking to you.
No.
Time and time again, it bests us. Every single time. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of us constantly losing. Elnaril's right. We have to commit more. We can't just sit idly by and let things play out the right way, can we?
I mean, we weren't sitting idly by.
But we fail every time.
We're trying.
Not hard enough. We were given gifts and we don't use them as much as we should. I know that Elnaril takes... You've seen him, I know you have. The way he appears. But that's because he's willing to put more into it than we have been. We sit in our safe places, only reappearing when it is most needed of us, and we still fail.
What can we do differently? Tell me.
We use the gifts that we were given. Why else would we have been bound to it? So, I will make that sacrifice and I will give you what it is you need to continue moving forward.
And just nod in resolve.
Very well. So it shall be. And the being stands up, and you see arcane threads begin to run around your body, wrapping around. You could see them begin to stitch your wounds, slowly. The world around you seems frozen as all of this is happening. Nobody's moving. Sort of grayness to it all. But you feel revived. You feel strength coming back to your body. And the creature, you walk away, say, let's make the best of it this time. This loop is the last loop. I need you to gain one level in Warlock. Your patron is the Weaver.
The fuck?
Whoa. You just made a deal.
Oh my god. Oh god, how the fuck do I do this? I don't know how to multi-class.
Yeah, you can do that after the fact.
Okay, gotcha.
For the rest of this fight, because you have no idea what just happened to you, you heal to full. As the world returns back, the time that was once stopped resumes. As you stand back up and look at the creature before you. For the remainder of this fight, you will have three legendary actions.
Ooh.
And legendary resistance.
Oh my god.
You regain all of your spell slots.
What the fuck just happened?
As you return back, and Nox takes measure of everything. And V, you could see him crying. And just saying, not again, not again, not, they cannot leave me again. And then he will close his eyes and press his hands forward, and just a storm of arcane threads will come out. They begin to wrap around everybody. V, you watch as all of their wounds get stitched up. Every single one of you heals for 23 points of damage. As you're allowed to stand back up.
Holy shit, guys.
Holy fuck.
I have legendary reactions.
It's me, you're up.
As the tapestry of this adventure unfolds, you can change the weaves of fate by liking and sharing these tales. Keep a watchful eye by subscribing, and leave a comment that could shape the future of this world. Farewell for now, Observer. Until next time.